For those of you who don't know me, my name's Mrs. Toward and I'm the chaplain here at Bishop Stopford School. I would like to welcome you to a very different Christmas service this year. I decided last year to call this year's service Hidden Treasure, which now seems quite apt, as we all need to find some treasure to lift our spirits in these very strange times. So let us remember that Jesus was a hidden treasure who also went through very dark times. Therefore, whatever you're going through physically, emotionally, or financially at the moment, I pray that just as diamonds have to go through an enormous amount of pressure to emerge into the most beautiful of jewels, we may emerge from this dark period of time to discover the beauty surrounding us and in others. Let us focus on God's heart of love through Jesus the Christ child this Christmas season, finding joy as we share this love in the understanding, support and compassion we show to those around us, coming together in unity to make these times a little easier for one another as we look for and find hope for our future. May you be blessed by our Christmas service this year and the work produced by the students and staff as they share the treasure that they have found in these very difficult circumstances. Now, please enjoy some of our school's hidden treasure. Thank you.
Once in Royal David City, a cappella. Once in Royal David City stood a lowly cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild, Jesus Christ, her little child.
A reading from Luke's Gospel. The birth of Jesus. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
He leads his children on to the place where he is gone.
The Christmas kindness. This year has shown me the kindness in the world. People call their loved ones to see if they are okay. People go in shopping for their friends or family. People stand outside and clap to show support to NHS. And people draw in rainbows in their windows to make children smile. And hopefully you should just remember this Christmas to keep the spirit flowing. A simple act of kindness is what you need to be showing.
This year has been very strange with all that's been going on. No birthday parties blowing out candles, this has all sadly gone. This new way of life is nowhere near normal. We're missing out on so much. Can't see friends and families up close, phone calls and Zoom to keep in touch. Baking cakes and reading books, walks in any weather. Moving away from technology, bringing families together. Less cars on the roads, more birds in the trees. The world is getting better. Less plastic in our seas. Christmas won't be normal, no carol service this year, but there can still be fun and laughter, we can still spread Christmas cheer. The baby in the manger, angels foretold his birth, the hidden treasure in the straw, bringing peace to all the earth.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of Jews? We saw this star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least amongst the rulers of Judea. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel."
Isn't it brilliant when you find something awesome when you expect to find nothing? Or when you find hidden treasure when you least expect it? Maybe it's Christmas Day and you've opened all your Christmas presents, and underneath the tree that was once full to bursting with presents, there's now nothing but a few bits of wrapping paper. But then you look under the tree a bit more carefully, and hidden right at the back of the tree is what looks like just a bit of rubbish, but it's a crumpled brown package. Looks pretty unpromising. But you think, well, I'll open it anyway. And you open it, and you take a look inside, and inside, it's the best present ever. Maybe it's a year's supply of toilet roll. Or maybe inside, the cure for COVID, not just a vaccine, but the cure. It's hidden treasure. It's exciting, isn't it, when we find hidden treasure, something hidden in something that just looks ordinary and unpromising. It's just a piece of ordinary, unpromising firewood. But to me, there's hidden treasure inside. Let me see if I can show you. that package under the Christmas tree, and that ordinary piece of firewood. You'd normally just look at them and think nothing of it. You wouldn't even give them a second glance. You would pass over them and not notice. But actually, there was something inside waiting to be discovered. Hidden treasure. Something beautiful, and in this case, useful as well. Now, Christmas is about hidden treasure. Something which looks ordinary and unpromising, but which is actually amazing. In this bit of the Bible that we just had read for us, Matthew, the guy who wrote this bit of the Bible, tells us that some wise men or kings, or at least very important people, went to try and find a newborn king. Now, they must have thought he was really important because they travelled for about 3 years to try and find him. And when they get to the area, they ask the local ruler, as you'd expect. Important birth? Ask the local guy. And the local ruler hasn't got a clue. But then they discover that actually something had been written predicting the birth of this newborn king hundreds of years before. And this prophecy said that the new king would be born in Bethlehem. Now, many of us will have heard of Bethlehem, but they'd have said, what, Bethlehem? Bethlehem, really? What on earth can come from Bethlehem? That's a nowhere place. It's like when you meet a new person and you think you come from somewhere important and they say, oh, where do you come from? And you tell them and they say, where's that? It was a bit like what it was for Bethlehem. It was unimportant and insignificant. Now, in the past, hundreds of years before, it had been a place associated with sadness, with tragedy, and even with royalty. But that was way in the past, not now. But anyway, they head off to try and find this newborn king. And what is this hidden treasure that these wise men find? Well, they find a very ordinary looking baby with some unimportant, poor parents. So much so that they don't even have a safe place to lay their baby. In fact, this baby's first bed is an animal's feeding trough. And yet 2,000 years later, we still remember the birth of this baby and the place where he was born, because Christmas is about hidden treasure. This baby was Jesus, and he was God's son. And despite being born in an obscure place, despite seeming insignificant and ordinary, his birth was the most important birth in history. You see, Jesus came to bring light into a dark world. He came to bring forgiveness. He came to bring salvation, and he came to bring hope.
Hark is the bell. Bill and Estelle from number 7, they bought a present. Was this for me? Who is this from? Just pass it on.
Ashtrays for smoke.
We do not smoke.
Hum, don't be smart.
Perhaps you could start.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Thank you.
place Santa for a day must spend on just £5 or less.
Can't I forgot, not have I ruled, what have we here, be of good cheer. My very own,
a library loan,
this isn't new,
it's overdue. Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
The box,
chops up on chops,
haven't you spread it, you're diabetic.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
As we celebrate Christmas after the hardest year most of us can ever remember, there is some hope, isn't there, with these vaccines that are being made available. But after the vaccines have been rolled out, will that solve everything? Well, no, it won't. After we can properly see family and friends and give everybody a hug again, is that going to solve everything? Well, no, it won't, because there's still broken relationships and illness. There's still hurt and suffering. What about a hidden treasure that can solve all of this? A saviour who brings forgiveness and love and lasting hope forever. Now you might think the message of Christmas is just a bit ordinary and unpromising. Something to pass over and to leave on the side. But isn't it brilliant when we find something awesome when you expect to find nothing? And when we find hidden treasure where we least expect it. This Christmas, unwrap God's gifts. Discover the hidden treasure inside. Someone wonderful and amazing. A message of hope through faith in Jesus. And I hope and pray that you have a great, wonderful and special Christmas this year.
Did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nation? Did you know?
Darkness, no light, struggles, no fight, agony, no cure, fear, nothing pure. Darkness sweeps over the land, a thick blanket of troubles. seizing the treasure and hiding its truth, killing the old and scaring the youth, isolating the weak and hurting the needy, robbing the poor and feeding the greedy, fooling the struggling and striking the good, stopping us doing what we actually should, stealing the treasure from down on this earth, but not quite the treasure of a heavenly birth. A hidden treasure of the highest worth, a humble king with an unexpected birth, hidden away, covered in straw and hay, the hidden treasure, there the baby lay. But what if this treasure wasn't hidden but embraced, and we allowed his rescue to heal our human race, bringing a loving whisper of hope to lead, to help us, we are all in need. As our Heavenly Father calls from above, a king, a baby, our saviour of love. This Christmas, as we call and mourn what is lost, let us look towards Jesus, and what a great cost. God gave us his Son, born to earth as the worst. But look at the shepherds, angels and kings, look at the hope and the joy Jesus brings. A hope that goes further than COVID-19. A hope that goes further than war and what's been. Hope that means we can know life, peace and love. Life not just now, but in heaven above, where he'll wipe every tear and cure all the pain. A hidden treasure our souls long to gain. But no one can reach it, bound in their chains. See, that's where this baby in straw and hay would grow up to save us on Easter Sunday. So let's celebrate our rescuer's birthday. 'Cause although he was hidden down in the straw, although this world hides him more and more, I'm telling you now, I've unveiled it for you. 'Cause your God wants you to have this joy too. So really, this treasure isn't hidden at all, but a loving whisper of hope as your Father calls.
Dear God, there are several people in these times who are suffering from pain, loss and anxiety. Please help them to overcome these problems and help them to face all challenges along the road that they travel on. Amen.
Dear God, we pray for the people who need you most this Christmas, the people who may not be able to afford to put a meal on their table for their family, or others who have lost a family member or friend due to the crisis. We also pray for people who might have very close family who are shielding and cannot spend time with them this Christmas.
Dear Lord, please help the weakest at this time. People that are jobless, people that are homeless, people that have been hurt and offended by George Floyd's death and the Black Lives Matter protests. God, we pray for the families who will not get Christmas presents this year. Children in poverty, war, jobless and people affected by COVID-19. Thank you. Amen.
Dear Father God, we pray that you will continue to protect all our school community. We thank you for your blessings on us and that we have a blessed life. We pray that you will look after all the vulnerable people in society, whether it is due to the coronavirus or not. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Dear God, during this difficult time, we thank you for the key workers that are helping us through this unusual time. Please continue to support the doctors and nurses who are sacrificing their lives and putting others first just as you did. We pray that your light will guide us and continue to bless those in need. Amen.
Dear God, thank you for the word you have given us, for the food, for clothes and for warmth. Even though many people have these things, let us remember the others that don't. A lot of people are on the streets, sleeping in the dark and watching others walk by with food. These people need help during this time, and so do the sick. The homeless need food and a home. The sick want to see their families sometime for one last time to say, I love you. The world needs saving. Please help us once again. Thank you, God. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
As our Christmas service draws to a close, it is only left for me to wish you a very joyous and peaceful conclusion to what has been a very difficult year. And now, may the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen.